طلبتنا أعزاء، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. آسف للتأخير، المحاضرة اليوم هي على blood pressure and how to regulate blood pressure. هي continuation for the previous lecture on blood vessel. خل أقول لكم شغلة، أنه تعرفون أنتو الكارديوفاسكولار سيستم has lots of details and وإذا نحذف كلام من عنده راح يأثر على المعنى وراح ما تفتهمون the consequences of function of each part. فنبدأ بالبلاد بريشر. هو شنو البريشر؟ البلاد بريشر هو the pressure that affect the blood vessel so that there will be an exertion of pressure on the arterial wall. Pressure inside the arteries that press on the wall. This is the blood pressure. Usually it comes from the cardiac pump where it has two part of the blood pressure, either systolic or diastolic. Systolic, when the heart pump the blood from the ventricle, the left and the right, while the diastolic is the pressure that push from the vessel wall due to its elasticity. The systolic blood pressure normally in young adult هو about 120 millimeter mercury. ماشي، يعني it increase a little bit gradually until it become about more than 140 millimeter for the systolic. Okay. So blood pressure is produced by ejection of blood into the aorta during late ventricular systole, which is about 140 from the beginning, represents systolic hypertension. This can be seen in the old age, but young age, the average is 120. It could be 130, 135, it could be even 101 for young people, especially the female. The diastolic blood pressure normally is about 80, but it could be 85, could be 70, it could be 75. But it's range from 60 to 90. The production of the diastolic blood pressure, it's from, as I said, from elastic recoil. يعني الضغط مال الارتري، الارتري مطاطية بيه، فالبوشنج مال البريشر اوف ذا الاستيسيتي اوف ذا ارتري برودوس ذا ديستوليك بريشر. اوكي، بيكوز واي ات كان جو تو ذا هارت اجين، بيكوز يورين ديستوليك بيكوز اوف ذا اورتيك فالف. اوكي، از يوجوالي كلوز ان ديستوليك. اوكي، ارتيال بريد بريشر IBP is often reported as the systolic, as I said, and diastolic again. Blood pressure value less than normal, lower called hypotension, which for the systolic is usually less than 90. If it is less than 90, we could say that this patient or this person has hypotension, arterial hypotension. When we talk about blood pressure, we mean arterial blood pressure in the artery. We don't talk about the pressure in the vein. Okay. Mean arterial blood pressure. It's usually diastolic, plus third of the pulse pressure. The pulse pressure is the difference between systolic and diastolic, which is usually about 40. The function of arterial blood pressure. Why there is a blood pressure from artery? Why there is a blood pressure? Because it maintains the blood can reach the tissue, what they call it tissue perfusion, including those lying above the heart. So even the blood can goes above the heart to the neck and to the head because of this blood pressure, whether it is systolic or diastolic. It produces the capillary hydrostatic pressure. So inside the capillary, there is a hydrostatic pressure. That pressure can let the the fluid to go out of the arteriole, and also the nutrition and the solute, okay, because of the difference in the between the wall, the membrane of the arteriole. Okay, this is the main force for maintaining fluid formation between the cells of the tissue, what they call it interstitial tissue. Diastolic blood pressure perform the following function: maintain blood flow, as I said, during ventricular diastole, so the blood flow continue to the tissue. So there is a continuous perfusion to the tissue of the body. So it is not intermittent. Although there is systolic and diastolic, but it is not intermittent. Even during diastole, there is what they call it perfusion, and still there is flow of blood and nutrient to the tissue. So it is essential for the normal coronary blood flow. This is for the coronary. It prevents blood stasis in the artery during ventricular diastole. So during ventricular diastole, still there is perfusion, there is supply of continuous blood pass through the arteries, even in diastolic, when the heart at rest. Measurement of the arterial blood pressure. This is performed by the sphygmomanometer, جهاز الضغط, usually هو الزئبقي. الكونتين اون انفلام ان شاء الله بالعمل ان شاء الله اذا ترجعون تداومون راح نشوفكم الجهاز ونقسمه اقسامه ونفتح اقسامه وراح تشوفون هاو تو ورك. It has inflatable rubber cuff, هاي اللي تصير على الارم above the cubital fossa, ماشي. And it has a tube, connect two tubes, one for the pressure, one for the release. الكاف connected to the mercury, جهاز الضغط اللي بيه المركري مانوميتر, والكاف كان بيه ايرت, يعني يندفع بيها بيه تشوب داخل الكاف. This cuff can press on the around the arm, the lower part of the arm before the cubital fossa, so that the pressure will continue until it will occlude the brachial artery. شلون ندفع through the bulb. There is a valve, هذا نلزمه بالإيدنا, نسد الصمام, close the valve, and then we can push until the level of the mercury can go up until, for example, 160, 170, and we release it, what you call it, deflate, opening the attachment for the air control valve. هاي apparatus can we measure the arterial blood pressure by two methods. So هاي this is the sphygmomanometer, هذا sphygmomanometer. بس احنا how to measure arterial blood pressure, there are two methods, okay. واحدة هي palpatory method, يسموها palpatory method. We can palpate the pulse of the heart, they call it palpatory method. This is an inaccurate method that measures the systolic pressure only. So this method, they call it palpatory, well, that means we palpate, and it can measure only the systolic. They can't, we can't measure the diastole. الكف رب يعني تلف على الارم, so that the same procedure that I said, brachial artery on radial pulse is the end palpate. So three fingers, ان شاء الله نعلمكم بالعملي how to measure the radial pulse. The procedure, it should be three fingers, three middle fingers on the wrist, and we on the direction of the radial artery, so that way we can palpate, we can feel the pulse. And then the cuff inflated by the other hand till the pulse disappears. So احنا نضغط بالبالب والتوب inflate, يعني ينترس هواء, ينضغط, البالس راح يكون شنو disappear واحنا اصابعنا على الرأس على الراديال ارتري. ف this indicate complete obstruction of the brachial artery. ماشي؟ فمن يصير obstruction occlusion of the brachial artery we can't feel it through the radial artery. وبعدين slowly deflated تخفف الضغط. فنفتح الاير كنترول. هذا الباب الموجود بدينا بتشوب اللي هم وهذا راح الراديال باس نحس بي يرجع وي كان فيل ذا بلس ذا ويف اوف ذا بلس ات از فيرست بيكم بالبابل ذس از ذا يوجوالي ذا سيستوليك ات ذس مومنت the level of the column of mercury represent the systolic مثل ما قلت لكم هو equal to the cuff pressure. Diastolic can be measured by this method. Sorry, cannot measure by this method. Okay? Why? Because we just depend on our feeling by finger pulsation. Okay? الأوسكولتاتوري method. الأوسكولتاتوري method. This is an accurate method. اللي دائما نستخدمها نستخدم الاستيثوسكوب. That's why they call it auscultatory method. Auscultate, that mean we hear the voice by the stethoscope. Okay, so the systolic pressure, blood pressure, we can feel it when deflated. When deflated, the first voice is the voice for systolic. When the the voice through the stethoscope. When disappearance of the voice, this is a diastolic blood pressure. Okay. Higher blood pressure, about 20-30 millimeter mercury, till the radial pulse become impalpable. So نقلل الضغط إلى أن نحس إنه radial pulse become impalpable, indicated obstruction of the brachial artery, and then it is slowly deflated. As the cuff pressure falls, certain sound called We are now talking about the sound that we can hear it by the stethoscope through the second method, which is the auscultatory method. Okay? We call it core Tokov sound. There are more than one sound. And this sound can hear it. Aku diagram, which represent how the, what you call it, the stage of the sound that can appear. So the sound can hear along with the heartbeat. So when there is the wave of the pulse coming, there is, we can from the stethoscope that we can hear the beat, the sound. These sounds are produced as a result of, why this sound? Because the blood flow at the area of occlusion, when it is opening, there will be turbulence. What you call in turbulence? مطبات مال الماء داخل inside the artery, because it is not a stream flow, because there is a little bit opening of the blood to be passed. Other turbulence can cause through the brachial artery, can cause sound, and this sound is about 5 steps. Okay. At the beginning, when the cuff pressure becomes just below the systolic blood pressure, when it decreases just below the systolic pressure, a spurt of blood passes through. يعني فتحة صغيرة من ال occluded brachial artery pass the blood pass. So the narrow, this has become narrow because it is at the beginning, narrow produce intermittent turbulence. This turbulence can hear tapping sound. Okay, they call it first Korotkov sound. The height of the mercury column, when the first sound is here, represent systolic blood pressure at the beginning. يعني من تسمع أول صوت من ينفتح من بالسماعة من أنت تسمع أول صوت يبدي من أنت تسوي deflation تقلل الضغط بالفال. تسمع الصوت هو هذا systolic pressure. When the cover when the, you start to decrease the pressure, the يعني you still continue to deflate, تتقلل الضغط. هنا البرشر يقل, الساوند become murmur-like. So that the first one we hear it at the beginning, but the sound a little bit changed. This is very short period in millisecond. نسمع. الثيرد وان وستيل ديكريزينج ذا بلاد بريشر والاوبننج بيكم لارجر الساوند بيكم لاودر. هذا الثيرد تحس بيه ثاوند. ستيب فور وين ذا كاف بريشر ابروش ذا دايستوليك وين ريتش ذا دايستوليك تو فور ذا ساوند تو بي ديسابير. هذا التربلنس will become continuous because the vessel is still concentrated but it is not like at the first time, and the sound become dull and muffled. They call it the fourth sound. Okay, the height of the mercury column when the muffled sound هذا الرابع, usually it represents the diastolic blood pressure. الكاف بريشر بيكم لور ذان دايستوليك من كلش يعني الضغط دايستوليك. الساوند ديسابير اند بيكوز ذا بلاد فلو بيكمز كونتينوس بات نوت تيربلنت سايلنت لامينر فلو ذي كول ات فيفث كوروتوكو ساوند. سيستوليك بلاد بريشر اوبتين باي ذا بالباتوري ميثود اند يوجوالي 2 to 5 millimeter lower than those measured by the auscultatory method. Okay, palpatory there is difference about 5 millimeter mercury between for the systolic between the palpatory method will auscultatory between our finger feeling the pulse wave through the radial and the sound that we auscultate by the stethoscope, which is the, through the mercury sphingomanometer. Sphingomanometer means the tool for measuring blood pressure, as I said. The fingers sensitivity cannot determine exactly when the first beat itself. So there is variation in individual for the feeling of the pulse. Okay. As the blood travel, the distance from the cuff to the wrist, the cuff pressure is further decreased, thus recording a lower systolic blood pressure. So the blood pressure is depend on the distance. So the blood pressure in the arm is different from the foot because of the distance. Okay. This diagram اللي هو muffling the fourth sound for the stethoscope, and you see that there is start to increase at the beginning of the systolic from above, صاير شكله دايموند مثلث, يبدي الصوت below 200, this is about 100, let us say 50 or 60, and the sound start to increase and then suddenly sudden muffling. Okay, and the end the diastolic blood pressure. This is a diagram, a small diagram for showing the sound of the heart through the stethoscope. Okay, and there is gap here, there is usually they call silent interval that can happen between the systolic blood pressure. Okay, there is very small space. Okay, the silent gap, the silent during measuring the arterial blood pressure by auscultatory method. Sometimes, especially in hypertension, this gap can occur mostly in hypertension. The sound, what we call it Kortokov sound, disappear after the second. As you know, the beginning of the systolic is the first sound, and it can be disappear after 3 seconds. They call it the silent gap. Okay, and this is can be obvious in hypertension. Okay, above the diastolic pressure. So disappear after 3 seconds for a variable gap at pressure. Okay, well above the diastolic pressure, then reappear again for the third sound. This occurred due to unknown cause and may lead to recording of false low systolic pressure. Okay, because we can't hear, maybe we hear the sound of after the gap, which can give us a false systolic pressure. Okay. And because we missed the sound above the gap, as I said. This is avoided by either palpating the radial pulse while we are doing the putting the cuff. So sometimes we do it in clinical. We put our finger on the radial artery, okay, to see whether there is pulse at the beginning or not. Okay. Second, determining the systolic pressure first by palpatory method. So we can do the first method, palpate the radial artery first for the systolic, and then by the sphygmomanometer we can measure the diastolic. So it is may take longer time. هنا عندنا عنوان اسمه physiological factor that affect the arterial blood pressure. احنا نحكي physiology, for these factors are very important for maintaining arterial pressure or can increase it or decrease it. The age. At the beginning I told you that the age, usually the blood pressure gradually increases with age. يعني من عمر 60 مثلا, عمري 60 يعني اللي my blood pressure systolic and diastolic a little bit higher than your blood pressure. Okay, so this is the idea for the young of 20 years, while for someone age 40 a little bit higher, maybe 5, maybe 10. An individual variation. Okay, so it can reach 150 over 90 when a person reach about 60 years old. يعني أنا when I measure my blood pressure من شيك بغطي أفحصه إلى أشوفه 140 145 على 90 مليمتر مركري, I will not worry because this is my usual blood pressure because my arteries lost its elasticity, so it can't accommodate the high pressure. The sex, الجنس يختلف طبعا, تعرفون انه blood pressure in the male a little bit higher than female. Okay, but after menopause it can it become a little bit slightly female after the menopause. يعني من يصير female من يصير عمرها 50 maybe the pressure is higher than man, than the man. Body region. Okay, يعني اللي يشوفون انه blood pressure بالليل is different from the arm. Okay, because the distance. Okay, but it is normally it is higher in the lower limb than in the upper limb. Why? Because of the gravity, or for other reasons. Body build, physics. Someone who has good body physics, muscular, arterial blood is usually higher in obese people, for example, obese people. So it's proportionate to the weight. The race, The American people maybe differ from Japanese or differ from Asia, blood pressure. So the Western countries, United States and Europe, is usually higher than the Asian, for example, or those people are African. And this is because of many factors. They call it genetic, but actually the stress and the environment and the nutrition, the diet that they use. Diurnal variation, صبح أو الظهر, العفو صبح أو بالليل, sunlight or at night. So usually the blood pressure usually at night it lower. Okay, so in the early it is usually lower, but at the end of the day is a little bit higher because of the walking and the stress. Meals, the arterial blood pressure increases slightly after meal because of demand, need doing GI tract function, reabsorption, and so the blood pressure a little bit increase, especially in the systole due to vasodilation. They call splanchic area, the mesenteric artery, the superior and inferior mesenteric artery dilate to take more blood, so that for the digestive process after taking a meal. So it's also depend on the big meal or small meal. The exercise also in another factor. Arterial blood pressure markedly increase during exercise, especially the systolic blood pressure. Okay, the diastolic is usually not change. Some recently they said that it decrease, sometimes decrease. So during exercise, blood pressure, the systolic can increase, the diastolic stay as it is, or maybe decrease. The emotion, when someone under stress, the arterial blood pressure increase. This is usually, okay? This because of the sympathetic stimulation. During intercourse, during sex intercourse, the systolic blood pressure often increase during this process. Sleep, usually during sleep, is slightly decrease than arousal than you are awake. Okay, these are the factors that could affect the blood pressure. Environmental temperature, this is another cause, and I make it bold so that because in our area the temperature is high, usually about 6 months is a little bit high. So during hot weather, systolic may increase slightly due to tachycardia. Tachycardia can increase because the pulse rate increase more than 70, 80, 90 during hot weather, so that the blood pressure increase. But the diastolic often fail due to cutaneous vasodilation. So diastolic is decrease, systolic decrease. So the pulse pressure is increased during hot temperature. This is environmental temperature is another factor for causing the blood pressure to decrease or decrease. The gravity. انتو شفتوا انه اللور لمب هاير ذان ذا ابر لمب. So in standing the force of gravity increase the mean arterial pressure. So the gravity is another factor. Okay, respiration. من تاخذ نفس during inflation of the lungs, the arterial pressure show rhythmic fluctuation during respiration. So expiration and inspiration, the blood pressure is usually fluctuate. Okay, how it is fluctuate? It is decreased during inspiration. When you inspire it, you make what? You make negative pressure. Okay, although the systolic venous return and right ventricular cardiac output are increased because the lung vascular capacity is increased and accommodate most of the right ventricle. من يصير عندهم negative vascular capacity increase. during right ventricular cardiac output. Okay, so the pulmonary venous repair is decreased, resulting in reduction of left ventricular cardiac output and arterial blood pressure. It is then increased during expiration due to squeeze of the pulmonary muscle. Bill expiration, your chest wall, so it's a press on the vascular bed of the pulmonary. Okay, so it increases the pulmonary return and left ventricular cardiac output. So there will be more return of blood called venous return. Now we continue on the blood pressure, and now we are looking on the factors that determine and maintain the blood pressure. So we are start to talk about how to regulate and determine and حدد the blood pressure. The blood pressure depends on the heart pump, they call it cardiac output, how many blood per cc, I mean, that can push from the blood from the left ventricle to the tissue through the aorta. This is one factor. The other factor, whether there is peripheral resistance or not. Okay, when increased peripheral resistance, the blood pressure increase. Peripheral resistance, that can be due to vasoconstriction, due to smooth muscles inside the wall. And the arterioles are very important. It accounts for half of the resistance. Okay, when there is less resistance, yeah, I mean vasodilation, the blood pressure decreases, especially the systolic. And the third, as I said, the resiliency or elasticity of the aorta and large arteries. For blood volume and circulatory capacity, this is number four. So this is the last factor to, what you call it, maintain the blood pressure. Whether there is volume, that means when someone lose blood volume or he has dehydration, so it affects the circulation and blood pressure. The cardiac output and the total peripheral resistance are the most important factor. So أول اثنين كلش مهمة. Okay, in other words, the blood pressure is determined by cardiac output multiplied by the peripheral resistance. تقريبا significant control of the blood pressure الأول نقطتين, cardiac output والperipheral resistance. So هنا معادلة blood pressure شو يكون؟ يكون cardiac output multiplied by peripheral resistance. Okay, cardiac output شلون حسبه؟ systolic volume multiplied by heart rate. كم مرة الهارت ريت, يعني نبض, كم نبض بالدقيقة؟ let us say 80 pulse per minute. والcardiac output let us say that there is 200 or 180 milliliter multiplied by how many rate per minute. The arterial blood pressure is directly proportionate, يعني هو يكون له العلاقة موجبة to the CO2. ماشي, when the CO2 increase, the pump will increase because they want to wash the CO2. Okay, which equal to the product of the stroke volume. Sorry, this is not CO2, this is the cardiac output we are talking. Sorry, this is another subject. I will talk about the CO2 and oxygen, the effect. Okay, But here, directly proportional, as we said, it depends on the cardiac output, which equal to the product of the stroke volume. كل beat هي stroke volume multiplied by نفس المعادلة هناك اللي هي cardiac output هنا يسموه stroke volume. وحدة cardiac output equal to stroke volume. Okay, heart rate. Cardiac output. And now هنا effect of change on in the stroke volume. Effect of change. Effect of change in the stroke volume on the blood pressure with a constant heart rate, okay, an increase in the stroke volume raises the systolic pressure with no significant changes in the diastolic pressure. So the systolic effect rather than the diastolic. The opposite occurs when the systolic volume is decreased. Okay, so there is a proportionate and also vice versa. اشرح لكم اياها هاي مره ثانيه انه اذا كان الهارت ريت كونستانت من يكون الستروك فوليوم انكريز اوف كورس ذا سيستوليك بريشر وذ نو سيفنيك تشينج يعني ريز ذا سيستوليك بريشر بات ذير از نو سيفنيك تشينج ان ذا ديستوليك اونلي افكت ذا سيستوليك blood pressure because the stroke volume is increased and the heart rate is constant, so it's normally the blood pressure increase. Okay, while when the stroke volume is less, well, heart rate is constant, the blood pressure is decreased. Effect of changes in the heart rate on the blood pressure. The heart rate من increase, of course the blood pressure increase. With a constant venous return, an increase in the heart rate, of course, raises mainly, it raises the systolic, but mainly the diastolic pressure. Okay? With no significant changes, there is changes, but not significant for the systolic. The rise of the diastolic pressure is due to shortening of the diastolic period. Okay, when the heart rate increase, the diastolic period, I mean the rest period for the heart muscle is decreased because the heart rate is high. There is no gap for the heart to get rest, what they call it diastolic period, which lead to a blood accumulation in the arteries, thus preventing fall of the diastolic pressure to the normal level. On the other hand, the constant systolic pressure is due to decreased ventricular filling. Okay? Which is decreased the systolic volume or stroke volume. The opposite occur when the heart rate is decreased. So is vice versa. Total peripheral resistance. This is the second cardiac output. One factor very important for the blood pressure. Here is where the second we are talking about total peripheral resistance. هي مجموع vascular resistance within the systolic systemic circulation. So the peripheral resistance is a resistant within the vessel, okay? What we saw, elastic recoil. The pulse rate is essential for maintaining the arteria of the arterial blood pressure, particularly the diastolic. It is produced mainly in the arteriole, as I said before, and is determined by three factors. Okay, the radius, sorry, the نقطة رقم اثنين, total peripheral resistance. السطر الثاني, it is not the pulse, sorry, it is the peripheral resistance is essential for maintaining the arterial blood pressure, especially during diastolic, as I said before. We produce 50% through the arteries, mainly in the arteries, and it is determined by three factors. So peripheral resistance inside the arteries depend on or determined by three factors: the radius, al qutr, so or diameter of the vessel. كل ما يكبر كل ما أكثر. The larger artery is higher peripheral resistance. Blood viscosity, when the hemoglobin is increased, also the resistance is increased. And the length of the vessel. These are the three factors. Normally, the total peripheral resistance can only be determined by the arteriolar diameter. قبل شوي حكيناها انه الارتيريال diameter determined. Because the other two factors are normally keep consistent. Elasticity of the aorta, we already talk about this, because it is part of pumping energy of the heart, is expanded in distension of the aorta and large artery. This is like an energy pushing the blood inside the artery, which is for the diastolic. Okay, so is that the elastic recoil is responsible for the diastolic. Okay, we can give you this diagram. You can look at this diagram, which is related to the what they call it negative feedback control of blood pressure. I mean, when the blood pressure increased, there should be a reflex to decrease that blood pressure. So, elevated blood pressure on the arteries, it causes stretch. And stretching, it will give impulse to the baroreceptor. Baroreceptor are present in the internal carotid artery. Okay, and this give an impulse to the brain, to the center called vasomotor center, to inhibit it. Okay, so there will be a stimulation to the cardiac inhibitory center. Okay, and then increase vagal tone. When vagal tone means the vagus nerve, the 12 cranial nerve that give impulse to the heart to decrease the heart rate. So when there is decreased heart rate, means decreased blood pressure. Okay, this is the cardio inhibitory, while the vasomotor center is also inhibitory in the brain. It reduces sympathetic tone. So there are two ways. شوف الديagram هذا اللي negative feedback. إنه من increase blood pressure, there will be stimulation. Stimulation to the cardiac inhibitor center will vasomotor center. Each one go to the its related part. One go to the vagal nerve. Okay. To reduce heart rate. Okay. And the other one reduce sympathetic tone. So they, when there is sympathetic tone, is actually increase parasympathetic and decrease sympathetic. When increase parasympathetic, it means there is decreased heart rate. In sympathetic, the vessels become less concentrated because there is inhibition. Less constricted. It means vasodilation. Okay, so reduce the tone of the vessel, what I call it vasomotor tone. Okay, we go to another diagram. هذا arterial blood pressure control mechanism. How to control mechanism of arterial blood pressure. Okay, arterial blood pressure. There are two sorry, three mechanisms. It can be either very short or intermediate or long period or long term. Okay? The short period, it depends on the baroreceptor and chemoreflexes, catecholamine, and abdominal compression and CNS ischemia. Okay? While for the intermediate term, adjacent the resistant and the blood volume capacity. The effect of the on the intermediate term is by stress and relaxation, capacity of the fluid shift from interstitial extracellular to intracellular, and also arterial volume reflex, and also in the kidney the system they call it renin angiotensin system. Okay, for the long term control of blood pressure is by diuresis, and also the renin angiotensin system. So the renin, I mean the kidney, can participate in the intermediate control term and low control term. Okay, this is an easy diagram that give you an idea how the blood can be controlled, whether the control need very abrupt, sariya, short term we need to increase. For example, if someone start to blood pressure decreased less than 90 millimeter mercury, he start to fall down or start to get coma or become semi-conscious. So there will be a short-term reflex, very rapid reflex. Okay, so the baroreceptor sensitivity to the lower blood pressure and give impulse to the brain to increase the resistance and increase the heart rate. اوكي ذا ريمينينج عندنا بعد كم سلايد ان شاء الله قليلات كلش انكريز هارت ريت بيكوز اولسو ذير ويل بي انكريز هارت ريت بيكوز اوف انكريز سمباثيتيك انا حكيت هاي سمباثيتيك البارا سمباثيتيك اكتيفيتي تو ذا هارت اوكي السمباثيتيك كوز انكريز هارت ريت وايل بارا سمباثيتيك ديكريز هارت ريت Increase vertical contractility, the muscle become more contractible because of the sympathetic activity. We call ventricular myocardium on the muscles of the ventricle, especially the left ventricle. Vasoconstriction because of the sympathetic on the arteries and veins, so that blood pressure increase. Okay, through the big arteries, arterioles, and veins. Okay, the net result, an increase could have a net result, this factor, it can cause an increased cardiac output, increased heart rate and stroke volume. Stroke volume, يعني الكمية of the heart that can push or pump by the heart each beat. Stroke, ضربة, الحجم الضربة اللي تندفع. Okay, increased total peripheral resistance, arterial constriction and return of the blood pressure to normal. Okay, this is the low blood pressure. Increase heart rate because of increased sympathetic and decrease parasympathetic activity to the heart. Increase ventricular contraction because of increased sympathetic activity to the ventricular cardio. Number two, vasoconstriction, arterioral and venous, because of the increased sympathetic activity to the arterial and vein. They call it arterial chemoreceptor. So there is chemical substance that can sensate or becomes sensitive to the blood pressure. The receptor of these reflexes are located in the carotid, حكينا على الكاروتيد والأورتيك بودي. Okay, and they are stimulated when the blood pressure is reduced, decrease. We mentioned this before. Okay, so blood pressure when it is decreased below 60 millimeter mainly as a result of local ischemia and hypoxia decrease oxygen. That's why I told you that the oxygen can affect also the blood pressure when it decreases during hypoxia and ischemia. In which case they discharge signals. These signals stimulate, ignite the ventricular center. Sorry, the vaso center. Okay, they call it vaso control center. And inhibition of the inhibitory center. Okay, so the cardiac center in the brain, it can be stimulated, and at the same time inhibition of the inhibitory center, cardiac inhibitory center, and vasodilation center. This causes elevation of the arterial blood pressure by increasing the cardiac pump each beat. There will be stroke volume big, okay, and cardiac output by resulting tachycardia. Okay, because I'm talking about heartbeat means tachycardia, increased heartbeat, tachycardia. Peripheral resistant by the generalized vasoconstriction. Okay, so when there is constriction, decrease the lumen of the artery, it means there is more resistance. Catecholamine, okay, this is another hormone that secrete from adrenal medulla, suprarenal gland, that cause also the heart to be pump more pulse rate and more heart rate. Release of adrenaline medullary catecholamine. Okay, hypotension stimulate the release of adrenaline and noradrenaline from the adrenal medulla. Adrenaline improve the cardiac pump. So adrenaline a hormone that cause vasoconstriction and cardiac pulse rate increase by stimulating the myocardial contractibility, so that the and also rhythmicity, so more plus pulse rate. In high dose, adrenaline produce generalized vasoconstriction and increase the peripheral resistance. Noradrenaline is a strong vasoconstrictor. The two catecholamines, adrenaline and noradrenaline, act to raise low blood pressure back towards normal. So there is work on them that try to make it to the normal. Number four, the CNS ischemic receptor. This ischemic can give impulse to increase the blood pressure arterial. This can be response when the blood pressure become less than 60 millimeter mercury, which is it can cause a brain ischemia. Okay, it can be stimulated higher than 60, but when it's 60, it reaches the brain ischemia. The resulting local hypoxia and to a little extent also hypercapnia and acidosis. Okay, and also stimulating the vaso center, control center, vascular control center. Okay. So there will be maintenance for the cerebral blood flow. Number five, the abdominal compression reflex. So when we compress our abdominal musculature, بقلنا نضغطها البلد البشر usually increase. Whenever the vascular center is stimulated, the medullary reticular formation in the brain stem, they call it reticular formation, is at the same time simultaneously excited, stimulated also, and send impulse in the somatic nerve to the skeletal muscle, especially the abdominal muscle, leading to an increase of their tone. So when blood pressure decreases, there will be an impulse to the abdominal muscle from the reticular formation. This is an important mechanism to raise the arterial blood pressure, since it increases the intra-abdominal pressure. When there is an increase intra-abdominal pressure, there will be venous return. Okay? So too much blood go to the heart, so there will be an increase in the cardiac output, stroke volume means. Okay? And the end, the cardiac output, as I said. هنا عندنا intermediate term mechanism. This mechanism control the arterial blood pressure by adjusting the vascular capacity and resistance as well as the blood volume. They act within a few minutes after alteration, after changing the blood pressure, and their action lasts for several days. During this time, the nervous rapid short-term mechanism usually fatigue tab and become less effective. They include the following: capillary fluid shift mechanism. So the capillary fluid, there will be a mechanism of shifting fluid, okay, from capillary to the capillary. The mechanism occurs especially when the arterial blood pressure is altered as a result of change in the blood pressure, increase or decrease, and increase in the blood volume, increase the capillary hydrostatic pressure. So it's proportionate to the mode. Okay? Capillary also. Capillary fluid shift mechanism. This is one. Stress relaxation mechanism arise of the arterial blood pressure, stretch the arterial and increase the tension in their wall. Okay. Renin angiotensin. This is related to the kidney. Okay. This is another mechanism. Okay. When the blood pressure fall, lead to renal ischemia because the kidney is very sensitive to the decreased blood pressure. This will stimulate the hormone secretion called renin from the juxtaglomerular cells of the kidney, which acts on a plasma alpha 2 globulin called angiotensin. So renin angiotensin cause the blood pressure to increase so that there will be no renal ischemia, and also there will be no ischemia in other body. Okay? Angiotensin 1, angiotensin 2. Okay? An enzyme called angiotensin converting enzyme. This is an enzyme convert angiotensin 1 into angiotensin 2. Which has a potent vasoconstrictor effect that help elevate of the. So the renin angiotensin mechanism, this can increase the blood pressure. That's why there is a drug, هناك دواء اسمه كابوتين and other أدوية طلعت جديدة derivative كابوتين derivative cause the blood pressure to decrease, which is they call it angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitor. This is a drug, important medication for decreasing blood pressure. Right arterial mechanism, this occurs especially when the arterial blood pressure is altered as a result of change in the blood volume. An increase in the blood volume stimulates the volume reception in the right atrium. resulting in the following effect: generalized vasodilation, okay, or reflex inhibition of the secretion of the antidiuretic hormone. So antidiuretic hormone is an important, okay, to be inhibited, and this helps water excretion by the kidney. So when the blood pressure increase, there will be more urine excreted by the kidney through the antidiuretic hormone. Okay, secretion of ANB, arterial natriuretic peptide. This also helps salt and water excretion by the kidney. So these all these effects can occur to decrease the blood pressure. Through the adrenal cortex also, epinephrine and norepinephrine, as I said. But this adrenal cortex cause sodium reabsorption to the renal tubule. This effect increase the body fluid and blood volume. So it increase the blood volume, increase the blood pressure when it is decreased, which elevate the arterial pressure to the normal level. On the other hand, arise of the arterial blood pressure increase glomerular filtration. That means more urine, okay? And the process of what they call it diuresis. This diuresis means excessive water and salt excretion out of the body through the urine. Meanwhile, renin secretion is inhibited and angiotensin II is not formed. Okay, this aldosterone secretion is inhibited, leading to less of sodium and water in the urine, the opposite, aldosterone. Okay, this effect reduces the arterial blood pressure to the normal level. The importance of the salt, especially the sodium chloride, in the arterial blood pressure. انتو كلكم تعرفون normally تسمعون دائما اللي عنده ضغط يقولوا لا قلل الملح، لا تزيد الملح، لا تخلي ملح للاكل. هنا الميكانيزم increase in salt intake is more likely to elevate the arterial pressure than an increase in water intake. اوكي، يعني من تشرب هوايه مي ما اعتقد there will be effect of increase in blood pressure. But when we talk when we take sodium chloride, there will be increase. شنو السبب؟ that the pure water is normally excreted by the kidney. يعني pure water almost as rapidly as it ingested. قد ما تشرب سريع قد ما انت تدرر هواية. لكن when salt موجودة but is not excreted, salt is not excreted so easily. يعني الملح من تاخذه انت مو بسهولة it will be excreted like water. When the salt accumulate in the body, it increases the extracellular fluid volume, لأنه it take with it water, sodium take with it water. The extracellular fluid, more extracellular fluid, that means more fluid in the blood vessels. شنو reason? Two basic reason. When there is excess salt in the extracellular fluid, the osmolarity increase, okay? That means it take fluid with it. And thus in turn stimulate the thirst center in the brain, making the person drink extra amount. انت من تشرب من تاخذ ملح thirst center, يعني center مع العطش, it will be stimulated, فيخليك تروح للثلاجة وتشرب مي. Okay, because more sodium, this is increase the extracellular fluid volume. The other mechanism, other reason is the increase in osmolarity by the excess salt. The osmolarity increase in the extracellular fluid, so we stimulate the hypothalamic posterior pituitary gland secretion. Okay, mechanism. So there is an excretory mechanism in the hypothalamic posterior, the pituitary gland in the posterior part, to secrete large quantity of antidiuretic hormone ADH. الاي دي اتش يصير كوز ذا كيدني تو شنو ري ابزورب جريتلي انكريز كوانتيتي اوف ووتر فروم ذا رينال تيوبول فور ذن انكريز سولت اوكي سو ذات diminishing the excreted volume of urine but increasing the extracellular fluid. Thus, for these important two reasons, the amount of the salt that accumulate in the body is the main determinant السبب الرئيسي لحدد of the extracellular fluid, especially the sodium. Okay? Because only small increase in extracellular fluid and blood volume can often increase the arterial pressure. Small increase in the extracellular fluid. Okay? Accumulation even a small amount of extra salt in the body can lead to considerable elevation of blood pressure. Thank you very much, and lovely.